half an hour discussion brought by SK Shun MLA to raise half an hour discussion on the Rule 49, Chapter 1 of the Rules of Procedure and Conduct of Business on matter arising out of reply to style question number 60. Sri SK Shun, please, only one mover, only the mover can participate, and you have to be brief and specific.
Thank you, Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, for allowing me to raise this half an hour discussion under Rule 49.1 of the Rules of Procedure and Conduct of Business on matter arising out of the reply to start question number 60. Sir, the subject of environmental pollution is a subject of great concern for each and every citizen of the state. As the reply by the Minister to supplementary questions relating to the principal question has not been responsive, hence this half an hour discussion. Sir, environmental degradation in the state has been a great concern in view of the fact that A, the rivers Umshirpi and Waumkra flowing through the heart of the capital city of Shillong has been classified and included in the list of most polluted rivers in the country by Central Pollution Control Board. B, Birnihat Town has been included in the list of non-attainment town of the country in respect of air pollution by Central Pollution Control Board. The illegal establishment and operation of 17 numbers of coke factories at Shillong, in addition to the 4 numbers legal coke factories, increasing water and air pollution on many parts of the state. Meanwhile, Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, stringent measures are required to be enforced to protect the fragile environment, including implementation of climate change adaptation program. The existing organizational structure of Meghalaya State Pollution Control Board is inadequate and under strain to cope with the increasing volume of works. I therefore request the Minister in charge of Forest and Environment to kindly respond to the following points. A, whether the state government by notification has exempted any area or areas of the state from the purview of Water in Bracket Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974 in line with Para 19 of the Act. B, unplanned and haphazard sitting of industries substantially increase the risk to the environment. As such, whether the department is contemplating preparing a zoning atlas for setting up industries in the state. Lastly, that is D, is the government actively considering the proposal for restructuring of the organizational structures and staffing pattern of Meghalaya State Pollution Control Board in line with the order of Honorable NGT dated 13 July 2017.
I would like to, at the very outset, assure the Honourable Member that as a government, as has been mentioned and stressed upon many times, we are very concerned about the delicate ecological balances, about the impact of the many activities that take place in the state on the environment, and the fact that we always keep such things in mind to ensure that a balance is always maintained. Having said that, sir, today the half an hour discussion which the Honourable Member from Moflang has raised is very pertinent to the functioning of the Meghalaya State Pollution Control Board. In particular, it refers to the start question number 6T, which was taken up a few days back, sir. So he's been very brief on his queries, and I would like to just, rather than read out this very exhaustive note that was prepared, sir, I'll just stick to the points which have been mentioned by him, sir. It may not be exactly in that order, the serial in which he had mentioned those points, but if I'm not wrong, sir, he had mentioned about whether the state government has by notification exempted any areas from the purview of the prevention from the, can you repeat that please? From the prevention of?
Act 1974.
The second point that he had mentioned was, this is in line with para 19 of the Act, correct? Okay. Secondly, he had mentioned about the fact that the organizational structure of the Meghalaya Pollution Control Board, State Pollution Control Board, is inadequate, and whether the government is planning to strengthen by way of restructuring the Meghalaya State Pollution Control Board. Thirdly, I think he had mentioned about the zoning atlas. On that day, because of the sound system or whatever the case was, sir, I could not really understand what he said, but today it's very clear that he has mentioned about the zoning atlas, sir. And which was the fourth D you mentioned? There was a fourth point. Only three, okay. Because you said D, so I thought there are four.
No, A, B, C, D.
So which is the D, if I'm not wrong?
D is strengthening of the board.
Okay.
A is notification, exemption if any.
Okay.
B is zoning atlas.
And the fourth one?
No, there's three only.
Okay. Okay, sir. No issue, sir. So, sir, regarding the zoning atlas, let me start with that, sir, because on that day, I apologize for not having heard it properly because I could not take his question that day. So the zoning atlas is for siting industries, sir. And this zoning atlas was in the form of a pilot project in the year 2001 under a World Bank aided project called the Zoning Atlas for Siting of Industries. Sir, this particular zoning atlas was very limited. It was confined to areas which were owned by the government in terms of industrial areas, sir. Therefore, sir, the zoning atlas for setting up and siting of industries would not entail those industries which were outside these industrial estates or industrial areas. Therefore, sir, the government went ahead and it came up with siting norms for different kind of industries, sir. And these activities for which siting norms were prescribed were pertaining to, sir, coke plants, were pertaining to stone crushers, to brick kilns, and to work vehicle workshops, apart from, these are the ones, sir, coke plants, stone crushers, brick kilns, and vehicle workshop, sir. So these siting norms now very clearly state, sir, wherever such industries, these four industries are set up, sir, there certain norms and criteria will have to be fulfilled. And I will just probably just for the sake of for the benefit of the August House, would like to just as an example, sir, read out the norms and the criteria for certain industries which have now been given these criteria by whereby which citing there these industries can be set up, sir. For example, sir, for automobile workshops and servicing centers, sir. Sir, the minimum distance from the nearest surface water body should be 20 meters. This is for automobile workshops engaged in repair works only. Secondly, sir, there should be sufficient space for storage of waste oil drums and solid waste. In the case of automobile workshops engaged in repair works, including denting and painting, a minimum distance from the nearest surface water body should be 20 meters. Minimum distance from hospitals, schools, office buildings should be 50 meters, sir. And thirdly, sir, there should be sufficient space for storage of waste, that is, again, waste oil, scraps, carbide waste, etc., sir. For automobile workshops engaged in servicing with or without works, that is mentioned in 1 and 2, sir. Minimum distance from the nearest surface water body should be 20 meters. Minimum distance from hospitals, schools, office buildings should be 50 meters. And there should be sufficient space for storage of waste and installation of primary effluent treatment plants, sir. So similarly, these sort of criteria are spelt out in various notifications for stone crushers, similarly for coking plants, similarly for brick kilns, sir. And because of the fact that, sir, the zoning atlas is only confined to areas which are owned by the government, for example, industrial estates. Therefore, these sort of siting norms were brought about, which would spell out the criteria for setting up these kind of industries in other areas. Sir, with regards to proposal for restructuring the staffing for, with an intention to strengthen the organizational setup and the structure of the Meghalaya State Pollution Control Board, sir. So this is, again, sir, a matter which boils down to the availability of finances and finance, sir. So the present strength of the Meghalaya State Pollution Control Board, sir, is such that, yes, sir, there are many vacancies in the board right now, and these vacancies, there has been an effort to fill it up, sir. As you know, the board is headed by a chairman who is assisted by a full-time member secretary, and the three branches, namely administrative branch having 70 numbers of sanctioned posts, the engineering branch having 17, that is, numbers of sanctioned posts, and the scientific branch having 51 numbers of sanctioned posts, sir. So these sanctioned posts all have not been filled up, sir. Sir, there, as I said, is financial constraints. And because of these financial constraints, many of these posts have not been able to be filled up. Have not been filled up, rather, I should say. We understand, sir, that yes, maybe it does affect the functioning, and which is why, sir, whenever the proposals have come to the government, sir, for agreeing to the sanction of following posts, sir, the government has agreed. Every year, sir, it may not be every year, but whenever the funds are made available, sir, these funds are given to the Meghalaya State Pollution Control Board, and sometimes one post or two posts are filled up accordingly whenever the funds are made available to the State Pollution Control Board by the government of Meghalaya, sir. So these have been happening over the years, and we hope that we will be able to slowly fill up these vacant posts so that the functioning is not affected. So this shortfall, sir, is something that is not just unique to the Meghalaya State Pollution Control Board. Such kind of shortfalls are taking place all across the country, even in the Central Pollution Control Board and other pollution control boards of other states. But nonetheless, sir, we, with the objective of addressing this issue, sir, we are considering the implementation, the implementing of strengthening, the issue of strengthening of the Meghalaya State Pollution Control Board. So the Honorable Supreme Court and the NGT has also taken cognizance of this problem, as was mentioned by the Honorable Member, and have directed the Central Pollution Control Board to frame guidelines for estimating the requirement of manpower for state pollution control boards, and have directed all state governments to adhere to these guidelines, sir. So we as a state government, sir, are considering the implementing of these orders, keeping the financial implications in mind, sir. I will have to just check, sir, what does Para 19 specifically state?
By notification, the government can exempt any area or areas from the purview of the Act Prevention and Control of Pollution, 1974.
Sir, I'm not aware of this, of the details on this matter, sir. Sir, I will definitely let the Honorable Member know if there are certain areas which are exempted as per Para 19, and I will provide him with that information, sir. So, sir, with this submission, sir, I hope I've been able to satisfy the Honorable Member, sir. And thank you very much, sir, for giving me the time.
Then is the mushrooming of this coke factories at Shalang a part of the plan process?
Sir, the mushrooming, I will not use the word mushrooming, sir. But, sir, we, as has been stated, sir, the stand of the government is that we have to maintain a certain amount of balance, sir. We are very, very considerate of the fact that that the environment is absolutely important, and we have to protect the environment. But again, livelihoods are also equally important, sir. And therefore, sir, one comes at the cost of the other. So we have to accordingly strike a balance and ensure that livelihoods do come up, yet at the same time, the environment is protected, that it is not at the cost of huge damage to the environment and the ecology, sir. So that kind of delicate balance has to be maintained, and that is our endeavor, sir. And the government has always been trying to ensure that that kind of balance is struck, sir. And sir, Para 19, sir, the Water Act of 1974 is, just to answer the Honorable Member's query, is applicable throughout the state, so there are no exemptions, sir.